My name is Nikesh Ardeshna. I am an epileptologist, a neurologist that specializes in the treatment of seizures and epilepsy. I work at McLaren Macomb as the medical director of epilepsy services. So the first treatment for seizures is always what we refer to as anti-seizure medication or anti-epileptic medication. These are medications that reduce the chance of another seizure occurring. There are many different anti-seizure medications out there previously. And again, this is part of what was known about epilepsy in the past. People thought that these medications were dangerous and sometimes they were afraid to take them. But part of my job as a physician is to provide education about those medications, the pros and cons of these medications. The important thing is that now there are many more choices. There are many different medications. They are safer to take. They do not need as frequent monitoring, and they have less side effects, and they don't interact with other medications. If medications don't work, do we have other options? And the answer is yes. There are different options. That includes what we call non-pharmaceutical options for epilepsy, but each patient has to be systematically evaluated for those. That includes something referred to as a vagal nerve stimulator, which is a device that's implanted in the upper chest. Another device that is used to control seizures is called an RNS, or responsive neurostimulation, which is implanted into the brain. And as another option, epilepsy surgery is a possibility. In fact, in the appropriately chosen case or patient where an area that the seizures are coming from is found in the brain, a resection or removal of that area has the highest chance of seizure freedom. If we talk about other consequences of epilepsy. Epilepsy has many other comorbidities. These are things that have developed and taken prominence, particularly over the last 10 years. Approximately 33% of patients with epilepsy can have a mood disorder, anxiety or depression. About a quarter to a third develop memory loss. Others have slow processing. Some of these could also be side effects of medications, but as a physician and an epileptologist particularly, I would advocate for seizure freedom and no side effects as soon as possible to avoid some of these long-term consequences.